Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer and welcome back to Dark Souls with the Fogwall Randomizer. Now, in the last episode, I made my way into here. I couldn't remember where I had left it. But yeah, I had made my way in here. Yeah, I made my way into here. I'm in Blighttown now. In the upper section of Blighttown, anyways. Okay. And got you too. I mean, they kind of asked for that to happen, didn't they? Okay, you know what? While we're in here, I might actually boost the brightness a little bit. Because this place is way too dark. Yeah, and that's just death over there, isn't it? Because I don't believe I can get to that platform. There's something in there, isn't there? Yep. I knew it. Where are you gonna come from? Are you even gonna be able to get to me? I don't think so. This is the worst part of this game, I think. Just in terms of all the dying to gravity here. Oh shit. One of those guys hit me. Aw, no. Shit. I don't have very many of the blooming purple moss clumps to take care of this shit, do I? Thank you. don't remember if poison resist worked for toxic as well. I think I might just stick with what I've got because I don't want to sacrifice the damage reduction I've got going. I don't want to sacrifice my defense for the resistance to the toxic. Because at the moment, I've got a few things I can take care of being inflicted with toxic a couple times. Hear them. There you are. And Blighttown is one of my least favorite parts of this game. This part in particular. The lower part's not as bad. But this part up here is always stressful. And the thing is, those guys give you normal purple moss clumps. They don't even give you the ones to treat the toxic that they inflict on you. Which is irritating. Doesn't something attack you when you go down to get this shield? I think it was a shield down here, wasn't it? Yeah, eagle shield. I was thinking something attacked you. I guess not. Wasn't there a ladder over here too? Yeah. Okay, something just fell and died. Where did this one go? gonna say, probably somewhere where I'll get hit by those toxic guys again, and then there was one right there when I came off the ladder, so, yeah, pretty much. I don't really remember this part. Is this? No, it's not. Oh, that's where I am. Okay. Okay, come on. What the hell? How am I not hurting it? There we go. Yeah, right now I'm up above the place I came in at, aren't I? No, I'm up above that other part, never mind. Power within pyromancy. Didn't that one make you a lot stronger, but there was, didn't your health like constantly drain while you were using it or something like that? Now I know there's big guys down here, right? Or is that a different part that I'm remembering? I might be remembering a different part of this. Is that an enemy over there? It is. Is that one of the ones that fell off the side? Is that where I think it is? Okay, where the hell is this gonna go now? Yeah, down at the bottom here, I believe, is the part that has the chest with a dragon scale in it or something like that. I could drop down to that platform. I'm pretty sure I'd survive the fall. But then I cut myself off from this bonfire. But going through here might go to a boss fight, so let's see. I knew it. Now, see, this guy's not that tough. It's just... Oh, I poisoned him. Awesome. Just those explosions, you really gotta watch out for them. Just don't get greedy. Shit. Ah, the poison finished him off. Awesome. Now, where am I going? Oh. Okay. Yeah, no thanks. Not right now. Maybe after I've hit this bonfire and spoken to Andre and stuff. That's good, I've finally found my way to this point. I've been trying to find my way to Andre for quite a while. I believe I should have two embers for him, right?
You must be a new arrival.
Not quite.
I'm Andre, if you require smithing. Well, be safe. Be careful. Why, I could smith some mighty wood. Why not lend it? Why? I can hack. I'll be seeing. Be careful. Well, for all my years in the trade, how's about? I'm just an old smith. best ore I get.
Now I believe that can get me to plus 15 weapons, can't it? That's 20,000 souls for that, okay.
Neither of us want to see.
Now, I bought those for a reason, because if I remember correctly, they get very powerful if you use them correctly. If I fight him, I'm gonna go head to head with him. It's actually safer. guess you weren't able to sell things in this one. Okay, so what do we have this way? Okay. Different part of Anorlando. Oh, the giant blacksmith is down here. Awesome. Now, didn't you get the hawk ring from somewhere here? That chest, I believe, if I remember correctly. Now, do I have to kill him to get to that chest, though? Can I go around him to get to it? No, he's in the way to get to that chest. Uh-oh. Okay, there we go.
Who are you?
Can't get to that chest without killing him, or without him being drawn away from here by something. Why do I swear I remember there being an item on there? There's something back here. Okay, I guess not. So that door's open now. Thing is, what if one of the bosses that I need to kill is through this side of that fog gate up there? I can't get up there. Like, not at all. Can I? I like how he's holding it with just his fingertips. he's literally holding the sword that he's forging with just his fingertips. And then just barely tapping away at it with the hammer. Well then, that will make returning to Andre and the giant blacksmith there much easier, because now I can get to them from Firelink Shrine. Just heading down Orlando, and I can go through that door I opened. Now, what's through here then? And Orlando. Oh. No. The elevator isn't running because Ornstein and S'more still alive. This would lead me up to Guinevere's room, I believe. Wouldn't it? I think that's what that room is. Maybe not. Sorry about that. As long as I keep doing this, I should be fine. Got him. That's another demon type knight. 4,500 souls from him, not bad. Can I reinforce this sword again now? Should I keep reinforcing this sword though?
Well, you seem to need any.
No, I need 2,500 souls. Okay, I was gonna say, wait, why is the fog gate gone now? now. There's no reason to go out there. Now this should get me down to the lower part of Blighttown, right? Or I should be able to get myself down there now. Maybe. Maybe, maybe not. I don't remember. Ah, I forgot about these things. Oh yeah, this is the lower part of Blighttown, isn't it? I'm just over by the Great Hollow, right? Or am I thinking of somewhere else? No, I can drop down here. I can go down here and get to the swampy part. That's right. So, before I get down there, let's swap over to this ring. Hey, that one gave me a blooming one. Awesome. Oh no, not these things. Poison resistance is not good. There's a bonfire right here. Let's get that. And there's the chest with the dragon scale in it in here. Hey, how'd you two get in here? I mean, I know how they got in here. I just mean, why were they in here? Hmm. got some nice poison resist on it. Better. The only problem is things are going to do a lot more damage to me now. Things. Okay, now. No, the pyromancer armor does not have better poison resist. I did not mean to use that. I meant to do that. Okay, I can kill it with just a normal attack. Now, I believe they could drop some sort of titanite shards. Was it green titanite they dropped? Large titanite shard, okay. I think they could drop green ones though, couldn't they? Like they had a small chance to drop green titanite? I don't remember. I'm just gonna wear the heavier armor and then just have to use the things more frequently. Because I haven't found the poison bite ring yet, which I don't remember where that was either, so I might not find it either. I need to be able to withstand more than just 2-3 attacks and I'm dead. And most of these gaps, as long as I'm careful, I can get across without getting poisoned. As long as I'm just careful about it and take my time where I need to. Let the poison diminish before I cross another one. Okay, I can kill it with just a single one-handed strike, okay. That's good. Yeah, I'm gonna get poisoned this time. This isn't going too badly. Now I can switch to this to make my way back out of here a little quicker, though. Yeah, green titanite shard, I thought so. Wrong thing, damn it. It is so dark in here. I had honestly forgotten it got that dark in here. Thank you. I didn't even get a chance to get away and use a homeward bone. Lovely. So those souls are stuck in there now. Damn it. I knew I didn't have enough Estus to fight that thing, so I was trying to get away from it, and it killed me before I could. Fuck. So I just lost like 18,000 souls in there. I mean, there's a chance I could get in there and grab the souls and get back out, but I might just get myself killed and then not be able to get them ever, so I might as well just consider them lost. Those souls are as good as gone. I thought there was something there. Guess not. Got it. Really? I know there's a bunch of those fuckers in there. I remember that. Which is why I never liked going through there. Still alive, huh? Not anymore, you're not. These dogs can kill you real fast if you're not careful. Lily. Firekeeper soul. I don't know what the deal is with why these dogs breathe fire. Is it like a pyromancer dog or something? Dogs trained in pyromancy. That'd be kind of weird, wouldn't it? If I remember correctly, this thing likes to push you off if you're not careful, doesn't it? Remedy. I think it was going back this way is when it would push you off all the time. Isn't it? When you go back from this side, it pushes you off the side of it and kills you. Part of me is saying that you needed to go quickly for it to not push you, but then part of me is also saying, no, that doesn't make sense. You need to go slowly to not get pushed off the side. And I don't remember which it is. I think it was you need to move fast to not get pushed off the side of it, if this is the thing I'm thinking of. Oh, I'm so nervous. Okay, I didn't get knocked off the side. Good. I did get pushed a little bit there, I saw, but not enough to fall off the side, so maybe that was it. Maybe going slowly would have made me fall. Like, if I had tried to do this over it, I probably would have fallen off the side. That I was seeing the shadow from down below. Probably. I seem to remember there being more of those fly things up here, but maybe those were the ones that I already killed. Key to Mulan Ruins. Oh, we're at this part of Sense Fortress now. Okay. Now, see, the problem is I haven't been able to get to any of the bells yet, have I?
Forgive me. I am quite honest. Or a gate. No matter how long I wait. So, here I weighing my op. Still closed. Still closed.
Yep, I have to ring the bell to open that. Oh. Cool, there's water flowing down there. Let's go on to upgrade my Estus flask. Now, hold on, did she sell humanities? I believe she did, didn't she? For 5,000 souls apiece. Do I want to spend those souls for that? There we go. I knew you could stab him through the wall. He's gone and done it now. So the thing is, he obviously left that orb there for us, right? Like, that wouldn't be something that a Fire Keeper would have just had, would it? Now the thing is, I can use that right here, but I think I'm gonna wait until I've gone out and hit that, hit that bonfire so I can have my full Estus. Or wait, you don't get full Estus when you invade him anyway, do you? Do you even get Estus? I don't remember if you get Estus flasks when you invade him in this one. I don't remember if invaders can get Estus flasks in the first game here. I don't know how he missed, but he did. And that worked out for me. Now, is it in the position right now where I can drop down to it from here? If it is, then I'm not gonna call it up here just to make it go back down again. No, it is not. I think it can only be in that position when you first find it, right? Because it has to be all the way up at the top for you to be able to drop down. That's what it was. Because then you've got the ability to drop down to that platform that's down below you here. And I've got this one all the way up to 20, right? I believe so. Okay. Now let's get up there and go kill Lothric and his lackeys. Because if I remember correctly, he's got a couple of guys with him. Can I invade as a hollow for him? I don't remember. Because I think for invading other players, you need to be a human. I know for being summoned, you do. Or for summoning, you do anyways. I don't remember for sure. Hey, he dropped a thing finally. Finally one of these guys dropped something for me. And of course it's his weapon, which is not that useful to me. Thank you. Yeah, I can't even use my Estus flasks. I can hopefully get rid of at least this guy. They just turn and look at him as he goes flying. Shit, missed. I'm trying to get a headshot here, but I guess I can't really, can I? Is it doing less and less damage? Okay, I might be able to take out this one too then. Gonna move back to there again, or do I gotta knock you back a few times before you do? And yes, I know this is cheap, but it makes the fight with him a lot easier if you don't have to worry about these guys ganking you while you fight him. Oh, I've been spotted. Gonna happen. Fuck. Not having Estus flasks there is a big problem. And now I'm out most of those arrows I bought. Thank you. least you don't lose your souls while you get killed there. Why is that not? Was variable damage on your weapon a thing in this? Because I don't remember that being a thing. Pretty sure your hits always did the same amount of damage, didn't they? Far away to do that. Are they all coming at me now? Shit. Really? See, the thing is, if I kill him, it's done, but it's hard to kill him when he's got these guys surrounding him. You know what? That might be a tactic, just iron flesh and then just tank it while I just cut him apart. I'll do iron flesh, switch back to my shield, two-hand my sword then, and just hit him as much as I can. And I'll have the Divine Blessing ready in case I need to heal. See, if not for the fact that I doubt I'd be able to squeeze past those knights over there without taking damage, I'd just ignore them and go straight through the door. But I think they'd probably hit me while I try to get past them. It actually is a little shorter to go around the other direction, huh? Okay. Good to know. How did that miss? Really? Did it just go right between his legs or something? Come on. And that time he had his shield up and it still hit him. I swear, these guys are just so inconsistent with how you can hit them and stuff. Fighting them is just inconsistent. It always seems to be... just... never seems to work the way you think it will. Okay, why did he not come at me yet? Really? That just wasted that iron flesh. I thought for sure he would have been coming towards me by now. Gotta get rid of the mage. The other guy I can deal with, but the mage I gotta get rid of. And I used the blessing, so now I don't... I have to get rid of that mage. There's no way around it. That mage has to be killed before I can do that. Just does way too much damage. I did notice that last time, not that time, but the time before when I was in there, that his two phantom buddies seemed to get stuck on each other on the stairway a bit. So maybe I can use the stairs to draw him away from them. suppose I could try that. Use the stairs to draw him away from them. And then if I can separate him from them, then maybe using the iron flesh and just tanking while I kill him would work. They can't figure out how to get up these stairs early. Okay, now they got it. Guys caught up too quickly, but that does seem like it might work. If I can get him to follow me up the stairs and those two get stuck like they did before, I might be able to do this. It just sucks that I gotta pull this and go all the way around every time. There's got to be some sort of trick to make this easier. Maybe instead of shooting the mage, shoot him. There we go. Now he's the one coming towards me instead of the mage, so he'll get here before they will. Killed him, but I got killed too. Please tell me that counts. It does. Good. There we go. Okay. Now let's return to the Firelink Shrine and restore her soul. Now you've actually got two options there. You can either return her soul, or you can use it to upgrade your Estus Flask an additional time that you wouldn't normally be able to, I think, if I remember correctly. Now, wasn't it also possible to use the... Let me check something here. It can be used to gain humanity and restore HP at the cost of losing the Firekeeper's soul to reinforce the Estus Flask. archer. Yeah, the Ring of Favor and Protection is a very useful ring to have. Even if it does break when you remove it, I don't plan to remove it, so...
Continue my duty as a keeper. But I only hope that my impure tongue does not offend. Forgive me. I am impure. My tongue never intended for restoration. Please, if you have any heart, leave me.
I feel bad for her, man. I think I might actually end this one here, and I will pick it up in the next episode. So that's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.